यस बेटा, अ वेरी हैप्पी इंडिपेंडेंस डे टू यू ऑल. फर्स्टली 75 इयर्स ऑफ बीइंग इंडिपेंडेंट एंड जस्ट बिकॉज ऑफ अवर पीपल हु वर्कड हार्ड फॉर अस. सो यू कैन रीड द कोट. आई एम जस्ट एडजस्टिंग द कैमरा. यू हैव माइट हैव ऑल्सो रेड दैट ब्रेक ऑल द शेकल्स एंड फील द फ्रीडम विद इन. हैप्पी इंडिपेंडेंस डे. सो सी दिस कोट इज एप्ट एज द ओकेजन ऑफ इंडिपेंडेंस डे एज वेल एज ऑन द चैप्टर ऑल्सो. On which character you can apply this quote? The main protagonist Murad is there. Uncle Khusro is also there, but he is on some another level. So we have protagonist Aram and Murad. Both are there, but Murad has a pivotal role to play. He is a kind of boy who believes in living life freely. Fine, but one should not. Yes, we should live free life. We should not have conservative thinking. We should not have rigid thoughts. Fine, we should let others speak, respect the opinion of others. This is the true freedom is about. But we people are taking advantage of our freedom. Like you people have the freedom of choice to choose between online and offline class. But what you people are doing, you're getting the facility that sitting at home at any nook or corner, you can attend the class. But even then, you are reluctant. So this is the wrong usage of freedom also. Today only 11 students I can see, 3 in the class, 14 students and total 26 are there. So 50% attendance you can say almost there, and 50% they are busy in other subjects only. They think that they are science students. Later on you have to realize only that how our marks affect us. So it is not one day attempt only. Clear? So let's start, not wasting much of our time. We're doing the Summer of Beautiful White Horse. Characters are Aram, 9-year-old boy. Murad, he's 13-year-old. Both are cousins hailing from Gargholian tribe, known for their honesty and truthfulness. Bahut baar kar liya apko, theek hai? So Uncle Khosrow again, and John Byro is the new character today. He is the owner of the horse, which has been stolen by Murad. Clear? But both of the boys do not know the exact, that real owner. And he's a farmer and he's Azerinian. Three of them are Armenian and he's Azerinian, but he has learned their language because of loneliness. He wanted to talk to someone. So he learned the language of other people also. And he is now, you know, forced to walk on foot. People during those days, they used to ride animals only as transportation system. So as his horse has been stolen, he's just walking on foot and he's so frustrated and tired. So he decided to meet Uncle Khosrow and tell him what has happened to him, that his horse is missing since many days. Clear? Now, one more thing I have written today here on this side. Guilt-conscious Aram and Murad are fear-stricken. So after meeting John Byro, after seeing John Byro in their own house, meeting Uncle Khosrow, talking about the missing horse, what will happen to them? He will be, you know, John Byro will be telling about that, no, your community, your family is known for honesty and truthfulness. So I don't think so. Anybody can do stealing of my horse. Fine. Whether they will be fear stricken that now we can be caught up by everyone, or whether they will be guilt conscious. You know, there is some consciousness which keeps on pricking you when you have done something wrong. सामने वालों को नहीं भी पता है आपने गलत किया. आपको क्या होता है, यू स्टार्ट फीलिंग स्केयर्ड कि ओके अगर इनको पता चल गया तो. इन दैट वे सो वी बिकम गिल्ट कॉन्शियस. व्हेन अवर कॉन्शियसनेस कीप्स ऑन प्रिकिंग अस दैट यस यू आर डूइंग रॉन्ग. सो व्हाट दे विल डू, वेदर दे विल बी गिल्ट कॉन्शियस और वेदर दे विल बी फियर स्ट्रिकन, दैट वी विल रीड फर्दर. फाइन, दिस इज द मेन कॉन्सेप्ट ऑल्सो. आई एम गोइंग टू शेयर द स्क्रीन नाउ. सो काइंडली कीप योर बुक्स ऑल्सो बाय योर साइड. Fine, so we have read so far. We are on page number 6, beta. And we were reading when Murad was perfectly riding the horse, and Aram, when he tried, he fell immediately. And then he realized that my cousin, who's 13-year-old boy, Murad, who's considered crazy by everyone, he has been riding the horse since many days. That's why he's proficient. And I'm not able to do this. And I'll be reading from that afternoon my uncle Khosrow came to our house. Fine, mid of the page. नीचे से फोर्थ पैराग्राफ. That afternoon, my uncle Khosrow came to our house for coffee and cigarettes. He sat in the parlor, sipping and smoking, and remembering the old country. Then another visitor arrived, a farmer named John Byrow, an Assyrian who, out of loneliness, had learned to speak Armenian. My mother brought the lonely visitor coffee and tobacco, and he rolled a cigarette and sipped, then smoked. And then at last, sighing sadly, he said, "My white horse, which was stolen last month, is still gone. I cannot understand it." So Uncle Khosrow in the house of Aram, fine. I'm not talking about Murad, so you should know. Who's I? Aram is telling you the story, na? So he is saying that in his house, in Aram's house, Uncle Khosrow was sitting, having his coffee and the cigarettes, and there came John Byrow, who was already acquainted to Uncle Khosrow, and he started telling him, "I cannot understand. My horse is still missing, and it was stolen last month." It means almost a month ho chuke that the boy has been stolen, that he had been riding that horse. My uncle Khosrow became very irritated and shouted. As you know that he's a very eccentric person. He never bothers when ever anything happens. When his own house was on fire, at that time also he never bothered. And now also. So Uncle Khosrow became very irritated and shouted, "It's no harm. What is the loss of a horse? Haven't we all lost the homeland? What is this crying over a horse?" So this is a satire also, beta, actually. So he's saying, "Humne to pura apna homeland hi khoya hai." The people who are into these tribes and all tribal areas, it's very difficult for them to survive, actually. The poor people, you know, sometimes they have to move to one place to another place. So he's saying, "We have lost our homeland. What about the horse? Kho gaya to fir kya hoga?" "That may be all right for you, a city dweller, to say," John Byrow said, "but what of my saray? What good is a saray without a horse?" Means he's saying that I cannot work in my home, a place, without a horse. A horse is required for transportation. A horse is required for all the acts he's involved in. Clear? So he's talking about, what will I do without a horse? My saray is there. "Pay no attention to it," my uncle Khosrow roared again. "I walked 10 miles to get here," John Byrow said. He's saying, okay, if I talk about the work is pending, okay, that leave it aside. Now I have walked 10 miles to reach you. Had I been with my horse, I would have, fine, riding the horse only. And I'm walking now 10 miles to reach you. Aage se wo kya keh rahe? "You have legs," my uncle Khosrow shouted. Fine, so he's damn bothering about what John Byrow is trying to say to him. Fine. "My left leg pains me," the farmer said. "Pay no attention to it," my uncle Khosrow roared. Again he said, "Then so what?" "That horse cost me $60, the farmer said. "I spit on money," Uncle Khosrow said. Keh raha ki I give a damn to money. So actually he's a very careless fellow. Uncle Khosrow does not even listen to others, not a good listener, not a good speaker, you can say. That shows that he was eccentric. Fine. He got up and stalked out of the house, slamming the screen door. So that was his gesture. A guest has come in and telling him about his horse, rather than paying attention to or helping him at least, or sunni le uski baat. He slammed the door and walked out of there. My mother explained. Aram's mother was sitting there. Usko bura laga ki what Uncle Khosrow, you know, behaved very badly to John Byrow. She started giving explanation to John Byrow. Wo kehti hai, "He has a gentle heart," she said. "It is simply that he is homesick and such a large man." So, beta, is line ke piche bhi ek, it is a kind of emotion attached to. We see people are very rude. We see people behave, misbehave actually. But we never try to find the reason why do they misbehave. Wo aisa kyun hai log? Maybe they have not been loved by anyone. That's why they behave like that. Maybe they, the way Uncle Khosrow, dekho, giant body hai uski, so huge. But at heart of hearts, he's having nostalgia. What is nostalgia? When you start missing any past moment. आप पास्ट में चले जाते हो, मे बी सपोज आप अपना घर छोड़ के कहीं पे रह रहे हो, हॉस्टल में आ गए हो, यू आर मिसिंग योर होम बैडली, दैट इज नॉस्टैल्जिया. यू हैव टू शिफ्ट टू अनदर सिटी बिकॉज योर फादर शिफ्टेड, यू आर मिसिंग योर ऑन सिटी, दैट इज नॉस्टैल्जिया. सो ही इज एक्चुअली ही हैज टू शिफ्ट, ही हैज टू लीव हिज होम लैंड एंड नाउ दे शिफ्टेड देयर एंड ही हैज बिकम वेरी रूड बिकॉज ऑफ दैट. क्लियर? So, उसकी मदर एडम की एक्सप्लेन करती है जॉन बायरो को दैट ही इज अ वेरी जेंटल हार्ट, इट इज सिंपली दैट ही इज होमसिक इन सच अ लार्ज मैन. द फार्मर वेंट अवे एंड आई रैन ओवर टू माय कजन मुराद्स हाउस. सो जॉन बायरो सॉ दैट नथिंग इज हैपनिंग हियर, नोबडी इज हेल्पिंग मी, ही वेंट आउट. एडम वाज स्केयर्ड नाउ, ही नोज द रियलिटी एंड मुराद वाज नॉट नोइंग इवन दैट जॉन बायरो इज द रियल ओनर. So Aram ran towards his cousin Murad's house. He was sitting under a peach tree. Peach is a fruit, beta, you know that. Trying to repair the hurt wing of a young robin. Robin is a singing bird. A sweet sa chota sa bird hota hai, which is known for its singing. Which could not fly, he was talking to the bird. So this is another side of Murad also. That he's very fond of animals and birds. Fine, the way he handled the horse was very good. And now one bird got injured and Murad was just repairing the wing of that robin bird. That shows that he's having human heart. So Aram ran towards him and he saw, what is it? He said, and he was, you know, heavily breathing. He says, the farmer, John Byrow, I said, he visited our house. He wants his horse. You have had it a month. अब उसको समझ में आया, उसके कजन ने नहीं बताया था उसको दैट ही हैज बीन राइडिंग सिंस अ मंथ ओनली. कहता है वन मंथ हो चुके दैट यू हैव बीन डूइंग दिस, आई वांट यू टू प्रॉमिस नॉट टू टेक इट बैक अंटिल आई लर्न टू राइड. आपको क्या लगा दैट इमीडिएटली ही इज रनिंग सो दैट ही विल से दैट ओ माय गॉड जॉन बायरो इज देयर, ही इज रनिंग टू से डोंट गिव इट बैक बिकॉज माय टर्न इज येट नॉट ओवर टू लर्न, यू हैव लर्न द राइडिंग, मेरी टर्न तो रह ही गई है. Fine, and you just informed me later on. So that's why that was the reason. आगे से वो क्या कहते हैं? Murad says it will take you a year to learn to ride. My cousin Morar said. He said you cannot learn it in 1 month even. It will take you to 1 year. We could keep the horse a year. I said. Said for keep the horse for 1 year then. I don't want to give it back. My cousin Murad leaped to his feet. What? He roared again, just like Uncle Khusro, he shouts only. Are you inviting a member of the Golian family to steal? The horse must go back to its true owner. Underline this. So this is the statement given by Morat. You should know, beta, objective time, kuch bhi aa sakta hai, dialogue aa sakta hai, who spoke these lines aa sakta hai. Better be prepared for anything. So you have to do the thorough reading now for objective test. So what happened? That shows that though Murad had stolen the horse, but he is not at all fear stricken. वो डर नहीं रहा है. But he is conscious, is still awake. He has stolen, he has learnt riding, he has been riding, but he does not want to keep the horse. He wants to give it back to the owner. And now Aram is saying, keep the horse, जब तक मैं ना सीख लूँ. What? He says, when I said, in 6 months at the latest, he said. इतना जल्दी नहीं कर रहा है, बट 6 months at least if you want to, but तेरे को 6 months लग जाएंगे सीखने में. It's not easy, if not year. He threw the bird into the air. So by talking only, he was repairing the wing and he just helped the bird. Bird started flying. The bird tried hard, almost fell twice, but at last, finally, the bird flew away high and straight. Early very morning, for 2 weeks, my cousin Murad and I took the horse out of the barn of the deserted vineyard, where we were hiding it and rode it. And every morning, the horse, when it was my turn to ride alone, leaped over grapevines and small trees and threw me and ran away. So after even John Byrow's, you can say, acceptance and telling that Khusro uncle that he has lost the horse, they were not scared. They kept on enjoying the horse riding, but Aram was not able to ride it alone. Fine. Nevertheless, I hoped in time to learn to ride the way my cousin Murad rode. One morning on the way to Ferjivian's deserted vineyard, we ran into the farmer John Byrow, who was on his way to town. Now the situation becomes worse. How? जिस टाइम पे वो हॉर्स राइड करके आ रहे थे, दैट वाज द सेम टाइम व्हेन द रियल ऑनर जॉन बायरो वाज आल्सो कमिंग एंड दे बम्प्ड इनटू ईच अदर, मींस एक्सीडेंटली दे मेट. लेट मी डू द टॉकिंग, माय कजन मुराद सेड, आई हैव अ वे विद द फार्मर्स, अंडरलाइन. कहते तू नहीं बोलेगा कुछ भी आरम, आई विल बी हैंडलिंग हिम, आई हैव अ वे विद फार्मर्स. यू रिमेंबर व्हेन ही सेड आई हैव अ वे विद हॉर्सेस, नाउ ही सेइंग आई कैन हैंडल फार्मर्स आल्सो. Good morning, John Byro, my cousin Murad said to the farmer. Horse was with them at that time. But see, do you think Murad was fear-stricken? He's not at all. Kitna confidence se baat kar raha hai, saying, farmer started looking at the horse eagerly. Good morning, son of my friends, he said. What is the name of your horse? Usko laga ki, this look alike of my horse. Why look alike? Because he can never believe that people of Gargolian tribe can steal. Itna zyada famous hai honesty and truthfulness that he's seeing his own horse, but he's not recognizing. It means he's not believing that they can steal it. What is the name of your horse? My heart. My cousin Murad said in Armenian. Usne bola, iska name hai my heart. A lovely name, John Byro said. So we are on next page. Let me move you there. One page we skipped only. So this is the last page we will be reading and we are done with this chapter. A lovely name, John Byro said, for a lovely horse. I could swear it is the horse that was stolen from me many weeks ago. May I look into his mouth? Look at that, my God, I swear that this seems to be my horse. This is my horse only. Let me check his mouth. There are some symptoms, there are some signs which tell you directly that this horse belongs to you. You are able to recognize your animal. So let me check his tooth. Farmer looked into the mouth of the horse, the tooth for tooth. I would swear it is my horse if I didn't know your parents. See the statement. वो कहते हैं कि I swear कि ये मेरा ही घोड़ा है अगर आपके parents Gargolian tribe से ना होते. So I cannot believe that you people have stolen my horse. So, but I'm very sure that this is my horse. It seems to be my horse. But because you are from Gargolian tribe, I cannot take your name. The fame of your family for honesty is well known to me. Yet the horse is the twin of my horse. Dekho. Honesty was so famous. Truthfulness was so attached to their family name. He said that this is the twin of my horse, but not my horse. But actually it was his horse. A suspicious man would believe his eyes instead of his heart. Kehta hai koi bhi shakki aadmi will definitely say ki this is my horse, but I believe in my heart. My heart says that you can never steal, but my eyes are saying this is my horse. But I'm not a suspicious man. I'm not having suspicion upon you people. Good day, my young friends. Ye bolke wo chala gaya wahan se. Early the following morning, we took the horse to John Byro's vineyard and put it in the barn. The dogs followed us around without making a sound. Next morning only, Murad and Aram went there and tied the horse back to the farms of John Byro. They would add somebody else. He said, I have a way with the dogs. Dogs saath saath mein ghoom rahe hain, but they're not barking at them early in the morning. And what does he say? Murad say, I have a way with dogs, that I know how to handle them. My cousin Murad put his arms around the horse, pressed his nose into the horse's nose, fine patted it. He's loving the horse. And then we went away. That afternoon, John Byro came to our house and in his saree, you know, when you have horse, you can again put your horse back to the cart. Aap cart laga sakte ho, baith sakte ho in that way. So he came back in his saree and he showed my mother the horse that had been stolen and returned. I do not know what to think, he said. The horse is stronger than ever. I do not imagine ki mera horse mujhe mil gaya ek to, and not only this, my horse has grown more stronger, more healthier. Fine? Better tempered too. What is the temperament? Behavior. He's saying the behavior of my horse is also changed. I thank God. My uncle Khosro, who was in the parlor, became irritated and shouted, "Quiet, man, quiet. Your horse has been returned. Pay no attention to it." उसको कोई फर्क नहीं पड़ा, horse गुम हुआ, horse आया नहीं आया, fine. So with this our chapter ended. Now the discussion goes on another thing. So let me have the discussion now. Now I would like to ask you all, and I, if nobody will be speaking, I will name the child. That person will unmute and speak. So you have to raise your hand. My question is, why do the boys return the horse? So Sahaj has given the answer to me here. Answer is correct also. The children sitting at home, raise your hand. Give very important question, beta. Why do boys return horse to the real owner? They could keep it also because he has accepted that this is my twin of my horse. Even then they returned it. So raise your hand. Raise your hand, come on. Yes, Aditi, you can unmute yourself and speak.
And because they feel ashamed.
Because they were?
Feel ashamed.
They were feeling ashamed. So you can mute yourself. Any other reason? So Aditi has given one reason. They were ashamed of this act and that's why they returned. Any other child? Ramanjeet, what do you think? Yes, what do you think? They returned the horse. So it means the you're not unmuting yourself. Nobody else is raising hand. So they were conscious stricken rather than fear stricken. Means when consciousness strikes you back, that yes, this is our guilt conscious, that you can say. They were not afraid. Had they been afraid, they never would have stolen the horse. Firstly, Murad would never have done. He was not a fear-stricken personality. He was very confident, very bold in his actions and words also. Aram was less, you can say, as compared to Murad. He was not that bold. But when he saw his cousin doing this, he could not suppress his desire to ride the horse. Fine. So Aram also joined hands with his cousin Murad. Clear? So they were not fear stricken. They were conscious stricken that one should return to the real because the at the stake of their family values, that their family is known for honesty and truthfulness. And if they keep on doing this, one day they will be caught up and they will be, the family will be ashamed and the family name will be distorted. So that's why they were conscious stricken. And out of this, already you know that Murad had already decided that after learning and I will be returning it back. For Aram now, he was keeping it so that he can also enjoy a bit. Clear? So though stealing is not considered good, whether it was for 1 month or 1 minute even. Stealing is considered stealing. So whatever these boys have done, that is wrong. One should not steal anything from others. But what they did at the end is also correct. Fine. Rather than keeping, they decided to return it back. So question answers we'll be doing. You will probably agree. First question is that the story does not have breathless adventure and exciting action. Then what in your opinion makes it interesting? What do you think? Probably a story ke andar beta koi aise adventurous act to hua nahi. Ki wo somebody is jumping and something is happening and some mystery is there. Very simple act, but even then it is interesting. Fine, this is the question they are asking. Ki koi exciting action to hua nahi. Then what in your opinion makes it interesting? Aapko kya lagta hai, Naman? You also tell me. How it is interesting for you? Any one point? need not correct always. Galat bol, galat bol, but at least give your viewpoint. Yes, beta. So this is the interesting fact that Gargolian tribe, that they are known for their honesty and truthfulness since 11th centuries. That is very interesting point. What else you can add up? So many points are there. Firstly, the Gargolian tribe. Secondly, the character of Uncle Khosrow. Pay no attention to it. The bold nature of that Murad. Fine. And how innocently Aram wanted to join, and we were thinking that he would be scared. Fine. So all these small facts, you can say small incidents in the story, they make it more interesting. So 3-4 elements you will tell. Second is, did the boys return the horse? Same question, that they were conscious stricken or because they were afraid. So they were not at all afraid. Had they been afraid, they never would have stolen the horse, firstly. And they were conscious stricken. Very important this is. They were conscious stricken when they saw that John Byrow is able to find the horse exactly the way he's having. So he's able to recognize the horse. But even then, he is calling it a twin horse just because of our family values, just because of our family traits. So we should not, you know, let down our family values. So due to that, they were very conscious stricken. So us time pe wo zyada conscious stricken ho gaye ki our family name is involved. People, you know, severe by our family that they cannot do anything wrong. So we should keep the family values intact. INTACT. Fine, usko mitti mein nahi milana chahte the. That's why. One day back there in the good old days when I was 9 and the world was full of every imaginable kind of magnificence and life was still a delightful and mysterious dream. The story begins in a mood of nostalgia. Can you narrate some incident from your childhood? Though this is better your this is for your open-ended question. That you can write any incident of your childhood, that which part of your life you still miss. So I'm not going to give answer for this. The story revolves around characters who belong to a tribe in Armenia. Murad and Aram are members of Gargolian family. Now locate Armenia and Assyria on the atlas and prepare a write-up on the Gargolian tribes. You may write about people, names, traits, geographical and economical. Again, this is your homework. You can read about this tribe more. So we are done with this chapter. And with this, your syllabus for term 1 finishes. Fine? But we will be doing some topics of grammar that I'll let you know. Clear? So next week, we are having 3 periods. We'll be concentrating upon solely upon writing skill and grammar, or especially grammar only. And then next week, revision starts. In that, we will be again revising the concepts and writing skills. Okay, beta? Have a nice day.